Welcome back again in LADALIDI's tutorial. Today's video is a short tutorial, so watch carefully, cause I'll quickly explain to you how to make this editable retro 3D text effect in Adobe Illustrator. I made this tutorial to answer a subscriber question on how to create this text effect that I made in the previous tutorial. So stay tuned and hit the subscriber button, give a like, and if you have question in the end of video, don't hesitate to ask me in the comment. Without any further ado, let's jump into Adobe Illustrator. Create a document with size 1920 by 1080 pixel, with RGB color mode. Remember, it's must in RGB. So we gonna create the background first. Create a rectangle with the same size of the artboard using the rectangle tool. Now, open the gradient panel, and click the gradient annotator to apply this gradient color to the rectangle. Change the color of these two color stops by select the color stop on the left. Activate the color picker below, and select the first color in the background color palette. And for the other color stop, select the second one. Next, change the gradient type to radial gradient. Also change the aspect ratio to 70%. Finally, select this midpoint, and change its position to 80%. Close this gradient panel, and activate the gradient tool on the toolbar. Next, lift the endpoint of this gradient annotator out off the artboard to increase the size. And done. We've finished this smooth gradient for the background. This gradient color is an old paper color, so it can give us a retro impression to the text. Now it's time to create the text, and give it some effects in the appearance panel. Create the text using the type tool. Type any text you want. Increase the size to 200 points, or it depends on length of the text. Here, I use the Rockwell Extra Bold font. This is a kind of retro font with an American style. Now open the appearance panel. As usual, I want to remove the default color from this text, so that this default color does not interfere with the effect we are going to create. Double-click the character layer. On this fill layer, change the default color to none. Okay, back to the default appearance by clicking this top layer. Next, create a new stroke layer by click on the Add New Stroke button. Give it a white color, 100% white. Increase its stroke weight to 3 pixels. And for the fill layer below it, give it a gradient color with an orange color that I have prepared here. To do so, just open the gradient panel. Left-click the gradient annotator, change the gradient type to linear. Change the angle to 90 degrees. Left-click the color stop on the left. Activate the color picker below it, and take a sample of a bright orange color in the gradient palette that I have prepared. Do the same for the other color stop with a darker orange color. If you found this midpoint still in 80% position, then reset it to 50%. Close this gradient panel and back to the appearance panel. Now we are going to add an inner shadow effect. Add new effect. Stylize. In Illustrator, you won't find an inner shadow effect like Photoshop has, so we have to work around this by using the inner glow. First, change the glow color to solid black. After that, change the blending mode to multiply. Opacity 35%, blur 15 pixels, and click OK. Now we have a nice inner shadow. Next, we are going to create a 3D effect, but not the real 3D object, although Illustrator already has that. Here I will only use the transform effect to create a simple 3D effect. First, select the characters layer to place a new layer above it. Add new fill. Replace the color with a green gradient in the palette. Open the gradient panel. For the color stop on the left, replace it with a lighter green. Select this color stop. Activate the color picker below it, and choose a light green color. Do the same with the other color stop. Click and choose green. Go back to the appearance panel. Add new effect. Distort and transform. Transform. Horizontal and vertical scale with 99.8%. Horizontal move 0 pixel, and vertical move is 0.5 pixel. And copies is 40. Click OK. The next step is to add a shadow effect to create a more realistic 3D impression. Go back to the appearance panel. First, select the characters layer to place a new layer above it. Add new fill. Change the color to 100% black. Add a transform effect with add new effect. Distort and transform. Transform. In this transform panel, change the horizontal and vertical scale to 93%. Horizontal move 0 pixel, and vertical move 26 pixels. And click OK. Now we will give it a blur effect so that the shadow that we are going to make looks more real. Add new effect. Gaussian blur. And change the radius to 12 pixels. Add one more effect to thicken the shadow. Add a new effect. Path. Offset path. In the offset path panel, just change the offset to 7 pixels. Leave the other setting by default and click OK. The next step is to add a curved effect like a bow to this text, but we will not give this effect to any of the existing layers, but we will add it directly to this text, or in other words, we will add a warp arc effect on the outside of these layers. So don't select any layer in this appearance panel. To place an effect outside of these layers, but text must be selected. Add new effect. Warp. Arc. Here we only change the bend, and I don't give a definite value because it depends on the length of the character we make. The longer the text, the higher the bend percentage to get a proportional curve, and for the word LADALIDI I give 20%. Leave everything else by default and click OK. And we have finished giving this text a retro effect, but it still looks lacking. We have to add another paper texture effect to make it look more realistic. So the final step for this tutorial is to add a paper texture. To do so, create a rectangle on it. Give it a gray color. Then for the texture, go to the Effect menu. Texture. Texturizer. Select Canvas for the texture type. Scaling 200%. Relier 4. And Light, with the top position. Click OK. Open the Transparency panel, and change the blending mode to Overlay. And we have finished creating a retro 3D text effect in Adobe Illustrator with a paper texture. That's all for today's quick tutorial from subscriber requests. If you have any requests, just tell me in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because I still have a lot of things that I want to show you about Adobe Illustrator. If this tutorial is very helpful, don't hesitate to give a like, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments. See you in the next tutorial.